So in this case, I have some text. It was created with a text object in motion, but this could be a picture, it could be anything, because we're going to reveal it. Instead of using it as a reference to draw on top of, we'll use masks. So we are going to draw on top of it, but the drawing will be a mask to reveal this. Let's see how it works. I'll move my plate to the beginning of the project, and I'm still going to use the Bezier tool as if I'm drawing a paint stroke. So B. The color doesn't matter, but because I have something black here, I'm going to draw with white. I'm also going to increase the default stroke amount. We'll see if that's about right. My goal here is not to mimic this, but to completely cover it. So I'm going to draw a curve. I'll command-click that one to curve it. Press return. And now my goal is to have this stroke completely cover the existing stroke. It doesn't matter how much bigger it is, it just needs to be bigger. So I'll increase the width until we can no longer see any of that existing stroke. So you don't have to be as precise here. The main thing is to cover the whole thing. Now that I've got that mask, I want to draw it on. So behaviors, shape, right on. Let's make that last for, oh, I don't know, it doesn't matter. We'll just trim it right here, O. And now that right's on, but I don't want to see that. I want it to reveal what's underneath. So what I'm going to do is add an image mask to the text. So I'll select the text and choose Object, Add Image Mask. Now, I could drag this stroke to the well in the heads-up display, but I'm going to have many strokes I want to use. So instead, I'm going to select this stroke and choose Object Group to put it in a group, and I'll rename that group to Masks. Then I'll select my image mask and drag this mask group to the well. Now, when I play, when that mask writes on, it reveals that letter. If you want to learn motion quickly, I have just the tutorial for you. It's called Warp Speed Motion for Final Cut Pro 10 editors, and I designed it for anyone who wants to expand the capabilities of Final Cut Pro 10, but doesn't want to commit to learning a full motion graphics application. Click the info button to find out more.